change here. It's caught up to them. Maybe one win sends them home happy.
Yeah, you can just feel the buzz in this city all day long, and we are seconds away now for this opening faceoff. The Ice have established possession here early in this one as they win the draw. Tried to make a move and the puck hops away.
There are times you try to do too much. He's got good hands, but maybe a more simple play is the right one there.
Denies it in front,
and he came out and challenged him. Good save.
Good hit on the play. The Jets get a hold of the puck along the boards. Gaining momentum along the wing. Dishes it to LeClair. Takes the feed to the left side. Moves the puck down low. A game of inches, and he puts it off the outside of the post.
Pretty tough to come much closer than that, James. Nobody can score. The posts aren't helping either. So often in a shifty little play, you're trying to get to the puck, you get your stick in the wrong spot, he steps on your stick, and there's nothing you can do.
Our first opportunity to look at the power play unit set to go to work.
This has been a stifling game. No goals yet. But now this power play has an opportunity yet to
penalty,
break through.
Number three. Two minutes.
Two minutes. That is not big. I have to tell you, that was a large hit.
Oh, what a net!
Missed by a large margin. You're right in the middle of the ice. You wait all game for this chance.
Here's a short pass to Nelson. Moves into the slot. His reflexes on display tonight.
In tight, he had to make an excellent save.
Here's the pass. That one's broken up by a great defensive play. Shots into the offensive end. Philadelphia's got the puck along the boards.
Swap up.
Now a puck pass to Barber. Can't find his man.
James, no real chances generated, no momentum game, just a couple of minutes roll off the clock.
Here's a shot, and that's blocked. Puck scooped up by Wheeler. Takes a shot, shuts him down. He decides not to cover it up and sends it away.
He's working his way through the offensive zone, James. He doesn't have an NHL goal yet.
They've got the defense outnumbered. Slides it across. He scores. Mark Scheifele delivers.
You don't get many of these odd man rushes, so you better take advantage of them. They moved the puck quickly and aggressively, and the goalie couldn't keep up to the shot.
Early in the first.
Always awesome to be in front of the game. You push the pace. You make the other team uncomfortable. When you're up front.
Oh, big time use of physicality in that one. Just misses.
No chance to score. You don't get the puck on
time.
Look at a face-off here as the puck goes out of play on that save. Plenty of playing time left in this frame. Winnipeg's up 1-0. Great read by the winger to take possession with the two centermen tied up. The Jets have it deep inside their own end. Feeds it up ahead. Winnipeg's got a hold of the puck. Sends the pass over. They've got numbers. And he slides it quickly to Allen. And the traffic neutralizes that threat. And gets it deep inside the offensive zone, allowing them to get a breather. Levels him with the hit. Hot poke over to Nelson. Pokes it away to Kane. contact from the left side. Sends it over. Oh, look at that pass back. Knocked away. Winnipeg's got a hold of it along the wall. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Nothing doing on that. Moves it quickly over to Simmons. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Picked up along the wall by Schultz. That's blocked. There's the whistle as the puck goes out of play.
Whoa, he takes that right in the face. Good thing these masks are good today.
Getting into the later stages of this period, Winnipeg's ahead 1-0. Charles won the draw. With the blast, makes the save! The Flyers scoop it up along the boards. Couldn't connect, although not exactly an ideal pass to begin with. Pokes the puck away. Looks to pass it to Steen.
Change up.
Winnipeg scoops the puck against the half wall. Moves it to Dubois. Moves the puck. The Flyers go to work on offense.
He scores!
What an effort to get this game back to trouble. You've got to continue to work even when you trail in the game. They did that, and now they have a brand new game to play. When you get into this position, that puck's got to be off your stick in a hurry. You don't have much time to think about it.
The centermen glide into position. Philadelphia's won the draw in the neutral zone. Finally coming up here by the official. Time's out of the puck.
Once the puck's gone, you gotta let him skate.
The Flyers once again send out their power play unit.
We've had limited opportunities, but the power play coach now has to get into their ear and give them a little space for it.
Well, this gives us our first chance to take a look at the team's power play unit.
This is a pretty simplistic power play. They like to get the puck, shoot it, crash the net, get it back, and shoot it again. What a great time to have a man advantage as they trail by one.
Sends it to the cross side. Moves it over to Scheifele. Grabbed along the board by Salani.
Conservative killing penalties than this. They make a mistake, now they give up the man advantage break. The power play doesn't miss on the rush.
Winnipeg's to even things up here to start this second period.
Nobody seems to be able to get the upper hand here. I've been really impressed with how well played this has been.
Couldn't find the intended target. Picked up by
Hammerchuk.
Good use for the play on the play. And now it moves it to the
1 minute, 3
slides
back
over. Here's a chance. Pass control down the court. Looking to break out. And now he moves it quickly to Connor. And it's a quick pass
intercepted so many pops in the middle of the air. Really good positioning. Their sticks are in the right spot, and they kept the game afloat.
Solid hit on that play. He'll keep it alive and moves it ahead. Good hit to knock the puck loose. Winnipeg's got it in the wrong zone. And that's broken up with a stick in front. Here's a short pass to LeClair. Handles the puck. Receives the pass. There's the whistle, and a penalty is coming up on this one. Slashing the call, and a pretty dangerous one at that.
That's way too big a swing to get away with. He's going to go to the box.
Another chance here on the man advantage.
I like the way that their plan has been successful, and it's pretty obvious they're going to stay with that same
move. Trying to clear the puck. And he gets the job done. Big 39 seconds. Quick pass to Barber. And a great save. Takes that pass back at the point. Quick feed to Barber. Big stop by the keeper.
That's in a dangerous spot. He makes a good save here.
And he slides it quickly to Giroux.
Goaltender to go two ways. He thinks he's moving to the puck, but it hits the defender and goes in the net.
Philadelphia's now got up by a pair in the second.
So they've got a two-goal lead. Some people say it's the worst lead in hockey. Well, guess what? I'll take the worst lead as opposed to trailing by two.
Yeah, you know, it's better than being down by two. Big
by two, right? By number seven, Bill Barber.
Here in the back half of this period, Philadelphia's got a two-goal lead. They'd love to build on it. Giroux's one possession. Now a quick pass to Kaur. Huge play in his own end to come up with the puck. Oh, he rocked him! The Flyers gain control of the puck against the wall. Right to the middle! That's it! He scores!
The goalie's going to look at his teammates and say, is anybody going to cover the high slot? He was so open, he was able to hammer home the one-timer.
Philadelphia's on a roll tonight. They extend the lead here in the second.
Everything they do is better than the other team tonight. This is a domination performance.
The Flyers win it. Moves it to control. And that pass goes awry. Philadelphia's running to go on the attack. He almost lost it for a second there, but they gained control of the puck. Here's a short pass to Lindros.
Murphy!
Pass to Connor.
In the second period.
Passes right to the front. He scores!
before he can really get turned around.
The Jets have got one late here in the second. What does this do for a team?
Well, it gives you a little bit of hope, but man, they've been so far in the hole. This isn't enough hope to think you can really come back.
Quick feed to King.
Number 81.
Here's a rip. Great save.
Number 55. Mark Sutton. Time of the goal. 19 minutes.
And we've got a two. Third period is just around the corner. Ray and I'll bring you all the action in a moment. Convert trailing here in this third. Philadelphia's got a hold of the puck.
After the icing, there's a little more pressure on the centerman to win the draw.
Philadelphia's got it along the wall. And it's blocked. Winnipeg's got the puck along the boards. And now he tries to get it across to Connor. Oh, he'll feel that one. Tries to get it to Prop. Feeds it to Core. They've got the defense on number. Shots.
Your head up.
Moves right to the middle. Winnipeg's going to have a chance to get some home cooking here on the calendar in the next little bit.
Doesn't matter how great the hotel is, how great the restaurants are. After a while, you just want to go home, man.
Agreed.
So now they can relax and play some games in their home arena.
Take it along the wall by the plane. Dumps it in. Philadelphia's got a hold of it against the wall. That pass goes a little sideways. And says it just out of reach. And we'll get a face-off at the other end of the ice.
Now, I like the rule they put in a few years ago, James, where the defensive team can't change. To me, that makes a big difference as to what was a pretty boring play before.
James and Ray with you tonight. More than half the period has been played. We've got a 5-4 game. Five!
You don't get the puck dead center very often. He's got to cop a lot.
You wonder if that'll come back to haunt them. They get it out of the defensive end. Takes the pass.
It's one, because you're frustrated, or two, because you don't like the guy and you're trying to put a little bit of a hurt on him.
Spoken from a man with first-hand perspective, right?
And you go to the box for both of them.
Philadelphia's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work. And the parade to the penalty box will continue as play is called for yet another penalty. Stick work will land him 2 minutes for slashing.
Now that's a frustration penalty. It's a bad one for him to take.
The Flyers with a 5-on-3, and they've got loads of time to work with here.
That's quite some time on the 5-on-3. What a big advantage for him. Take advantage of this opportunity. You take a two-man advantage slip away.
Quick pass to Barber, and he slides it quickly to Clark. That's a great heads-up play to bring up the pass. And they move the puck out of harm's way. The Sherry's got it in the defensive end. Lindros plays it against the boards. Directs it on over to Desjardins. From one point man to another. Scores! And the power play strikes again.
James, they've been working on this in practice for the last little while. It's come through big for them tonight.
Scores!
Man, this night is going well for him from the very beginning. He got the first one, and you can just see the puck is kind of finding him tonight. It's one timed into the net.
The Flyers continue to rack up the goals here in this third period.
They can do no wrong. It doesn't seem to matter who's on the ice. They're the better team.
Puck is dropped, and we are back on the way.
His third of the game.
Squash to the painted.
Been all over them tonight, and it continues here in this third.
They haven't taken their foot off the accelerator for 1 second tonight. I've been really impressed how they dominated this game.
Fifth of the season. Scored by
Nets are playing the defensive zone.
He'll be heading to the penalty box for a couple of minutes. That's a charging penalty every day of the week.
Winnipeg penalty to number 12. 2 minutes for charging. Time of the penalty. 19 minutes, 41 seconds.
The Jets get a hold of it.
Right.
And that'll do it for Ray Pearl. I'm James Cebulski. Thank you.
Thank you.